This, ladies and gentlemen, is the town of Hubberley, Hubberley, Montana. You'll not find it on your map, but you'll find it on your TV set. Every day, Monday through Friday, on CBS television. Regardless of the weather, in rain or snow, in sleet or sunshine, we will attempt to faithfully create the atmosphere of the Old West. Faithfully enact the great adventure stories of the great adventurous West. So pause now for this half hour of action in the afternoon.
Here in Hubberley in the past few days, that's for sure. The bank was robbed. We almost had a lynching. Jack Valentine finally brought in the two outlaws. Now what's he gonna do? We'll have to cell door open. Well, I guess Jack knows what he's doing. As one of the outlaws said, Jack's no fool.
In 21 seconds, the hard times hold on, little doggie, hold on. When a time of lasso, you're gone, you're gone. Make your feet fly, they'll be tied by and by.
What you got there, Ozzy?
I'm making a horse-like blaze, Jack.
Uh-huh. Real pretty.
Isn't it nice?
Hold on, little doggie, hold on.
Maybe he's going to get me a new horse, Jack.
Good idea.
On a ranch in Montana, we'll build a small fire. We'll rope and we'll brand them the way you'd admire with lariat spinning.
Howdy, Mr. Grant.
Well, how are you? And I'm awful glad this thing came to a proper conclusion. You know, robbing a bank is not good for business.
It's not.
No, people get funny ideas that their money is not safe. With law enforcement and all that sort of thing, why, it's not. So you're not listening to a word I'm saying. You got something on your mind? You're waiting for somebody?
Certainly am. Teddy, what you do?
Uh-huh.
You go to the general store and tell Sam to get down to jail, then run over to the record and tell Miss Parrish that the story's about to happen.
Oh, I think she's got enough material to keep us reading for a long, long time. What with the bank robbery and what could have been a lynching. Yeah, she has enough money, I'd say, enough time, enough work. I think we... The sheriff, you said. I'll get the sheriff. Jack, there's a fight on. Jack, there's a fight. There's a fight. Come on! Come on! Come on!
Thank you.
pass off those fellas.
Think what you're saying, Ozzy. Do you really know them? I know I've saw them somewhere before. Can you remember where you saw them?
I think it was out in the road somewhere. That's it, out in the road somewhere.
Well, now, wait a minute. Now, when did you see him? When?
I forget.
Ozzy, how can you forget a thing like that?
I forget exactly.
Well, now just try to remember, Ozzy. Try to remember, where did you see him?
It was out on the road.
Out on the road.
Out on the road somewhere. Uh-huh. They was talking to somebody from the Hubbley.
Uh-huh. Somebody from Hubbley. Now, wait a minute. Now, somebody we know here in Hubbley, huh? Huh?
They was talking to somebody, but I don't know who it was, Jack.
Ozzy, I don't see how you can forget a thing like that.
Well, it when I get to walking and thinking, and I see things happen, when I got the telephone, I can't always seem to remember, Jack.
Kind of confusing, Ozzy.
That's just what it is, Jack. Confusing because I forget so easy.
Well, you try to remember because it sure would help us. Now, I know you want to be helpful.
I want to help,
right.
Jack.
Now, you want to help me right now?
I sure do, Jack.
Now, here's what you do. I want you to take my gun here. Take my gun. Now, I got an idea where those shots came from. On top of the bank.
Uh-huh.
Take the gun. Now, wait. Pour it over here. That's it. I want you to watch real close. I'm going up on top of the bank. And if anybody gets the same idea that I do, I want you to fire the gun once. All right?
Hey, if anybody tries to follow you, to fire the gun, Jack.
That's right. Now, be all real right. careful. Okay?
All right, Jack. Don't forget, Jack.
Okay,
you can trust me.
Right.
All right, Jack. Hey, I'm talking to you. What are you doing out here with a gun, huh? Answer me! What are you doing with a gun?
I'm shooting a Pollyanna.
Come on, speak up. What's the matter with you? You can't get your tongue? What are you doing out here, Matthew? Speak up like a normal person, huh? Well, get rid of that gun. Get out of here. Go on.
I'm shooting a Pollyanna.
I'm shooting a Pollyanna. Get out of here. Go on.
Someday that muddlehead's gonna get into trouble, you know. Real trouble.
Kid don't get in any trouble unless he's put up to it by the likes of you. Had any good hangings lately? Simpson, you're just no good.
Listen, Valentine. For a man who's responsible for two guys getting out of that jail, you're doing an awful lot of talking. I'd mind my own business if I were you.
Handed to you for trying. I always did admire the way you handled yourself on a case, Doc.
A fella can do just so much. It depends on the patient. Speaking of that lake casing, I don't want him in my kitchen too long.
Oh, we'll bury him with the other one, Red. But doggone it, with both of them fellas dead now, I wonder if we're ever going to find out who's really behind all this.
You really think somebody in town had a finger in this mess, Sam?
Jack Valentine says so.
Nobody lost anything. What's the difference? Don't anybody move.
Sam, get your gun out and keep your eyes open. Everybody see this piece of leather I got here? It's off of somebody's boot. And I'm aiming to find out who. Now, nobody who's innocent would mind showing their boot, would they? All right. Simpson, we'll start with you.
Why, that's ridiculous. There's nothing wrong with my boot.
We're looking for the men who robbed the bank.
Well, why would I want to rob my own bank?
Why do men do half the things they do, Grimes? Now, show me your boot.
Well, surely, glad to, glad to.
Now, all right.
What's wrong with those?
All right, now line up against the bar here and stick your boot up. It'll take all day.
Step it higher there.
All right, Kenny, get the other one up.
What's the big idea, Valentine? Never heard anything crazy in my life.
Mitchell, and Sheriff, are you going to stand by and watch this foolishness go on?
It seems like a good idea to me.
Never heard of such a fool thing in my life.
No self-respecting sheriff would take part in this tomfool scheme as this.
I got a right to look for evidence anywhere I please. And if Jack Valentine's got a good idea, then I'd go for that myself.
Let me see your boot. What are you standing
for? All right, all
right. I got nothing wrong with my boots.
Turn around.
Now lift them up. All right, I see the other one.
I don't go for this stuff.
Let's see the other one. Simpson? Let's see your boot.
Listen here, Valentine. Nobody's going to get a look at my boot. Unless he flattens me first.
That's the way you want it, Simpson. That's the way you'll get it.
Sam?
Here's your man.
This explains a lot of things, Simpson.
Explains the reason for that big game the other day. Betting way over your head just to keep the game going.
And he had the nerve to ask me for money while his men were robbing my bank.
Now we know why you were so willing to hang Ozzie Matthews. Just to hide yourself. How low can you get, Simpson?
Come on, Simpson, let's get over to the jail. You ought to know where it is by now.
All right, come on.
All right.
Come on. Well, I didn't agree with your methods, Mr. Valentine, but I like your spirit and your determination. After all, you brought my money back, and you found the men responsible. That was fine work. Fine work.
Hey, Jack, how about a song?
Song?
Yeah, Jack, sing a song.
Fly one, fellas.
Did you get that off the road?
I'm sure it's Ozzie. Sorry, what are you sorry for? Well, I didn't say put when you told me to watch when you went up on the roof. I got the gun. It's not good for anybody to be up there at one. Thanks a lot, Ozzie. You see, I was okay. Always carry two. I saw them carry Mr. Simpson out and looked like he was hurt.
Did you shoot him, Mr. Valentine?
He was the man behind the robbery, Ozzie.
I know. I remember now. I know I saw him someplace. He was the man talking to those robbers out in the road.
That's right. Where he's going, he's not going to hurt you anymore.
I sure like you, Mr. Valentine.
Ozzie, you're going to call me Jack from now on, aren't you?
Huh? All right,
we're
Jack.
Good friends, huh?
Well, we're friends,
okay,
Jack.
Come on over here and have one with me.
Oh, no. I don't like that.
All right. You just stand here and enjoy the music. All right. Well, why don't we have a dance or something?
Hey, Doc, I want you to go on down to the jail there and help him.
Come on,
he ain't worth it.
Hey,
my God, we got to help him out.
Come on, man.
Song for the folks that fella brought from Texas a couple of weeks ago. Remember?
Give me my bridle and saddle and my old pinto I'll straddle. I'll get the cowboys a ride. I'll wear the rustlers a hide. I love the room much younger. I'll wear the buffalo roar.
Take care of the old timer here.
pay his bar bill for about a month. That ought to take care of it, huh? I want to thank you for helping me out. You're mighty handy there with that bottle, just what I needed, huh?
Near nothing.
Well, what'll it be? Large sarsaparilla. Oh.
I'm going to watch out for the stagecoach, Sheriff.
Oh,
I'm going to watch out. Come in. Hey, stage is coming.
The stage!
I'm always curious when the stage comes into town. Never know who's on it, why they came here. But it's a sure thing we'll find out who's on this stage next week, when there's action in the afternoon. Reminder, this Sunday night, that great showman Ken Murray comes back to CBS television. Cigar, comedy, beautiful girls, guest stars and all. Yes, it's the Ken Murray Show, returning for your pleasure every other Sunday starting this weekend. Ken Murray will be alternating on most of these same stations with the Alan Young Show, bringing back still another great comedy personality to CBS television. Which reminds us, Make America Invincible by Radar would take fantastic amounts of money, material and personnel. Because radar has many gaps, the Ground Observer Corps, a volunteer civilian army, has been recruited to scan our skies around the clock to keep America on guard. To join your local ground observers by giving a few hours a week, contact your local civilian defense office. History repeated, and you are there, Sundays on the CBS television network.